Spaced Out, 50 Years of the Merril Collection is a free exhibit at the TD Gallery at Toronto Reference Library, where you can discover some of the rare, weird, and wonderful things held in Toronto Public Library's world-class research collection of speculative fiction. To celebrate the 50th anniversary of the collection's founding, we are showing off our greatest hits, rare editions of classic tales and modern fan favorites, original artwork, pulp magazines, role-playing games, and more. We've tried to capture the incredible range of the speculative fiction genre: science fiction, fantasy, utopian and dystopian fiction, horror, and supernatural fiction. Here are a few of my favorites. Early science fiction. The Spaced Out exhibit includes some of the oldest books in Merril's collection. The earliest is a science fiction tale from 1751 about a land hidden beneath Antarctica where inhabitants fly on mechanical wings. We are also showcasing this beautiful embossed 1906 edition of Jules Verne's Le Volcan d'Or, or The Golden Volcano, one of the many rare editions of Verne's pioneering works in science fiction, donated to the collection in 1972. Other highlights include a first edition of H.G. Wells' Martian invasion story, The War of the Worlds, and the earliest work of Canadian science fiction from 1888, a strange manuscript found in a copper cylinder. From hard science fiction to space opera, the exhibit showcases how science fiction helps us to see what is and what could be. Fans of the 2021 film adaptation may be excited to see that we have a first edition of Frank Herbert's Dune, one of the most influential science fiction novels of all time. Whether set in this world or an imaginary land, fantasy stories deal in the improbable. Fans of the genre will have a chance to see early and inscribed editions of influential works, including a first edition of J.R.R. Tolkien's The Return of the King, part of the Lord of the Rings series, and one of the best-known examples of high or epic fantasy. Utopian and dystopian fiction also falls under the umbrella of speculation. Stories about ideal societies or the grim opposite, often to critique flaws in our own world. You'll see Jack London's The Iron Heel, considered the earliest modern dystopian fiction and a major inspiration for George Orwell's 1984, as well as more recent takes on the genre, like a 2020 graphic novel adaptation of Octavia E. Butler's Parable of the Sower. Like the word implies, horror stories try to evoke terror and dread in their readers. They also invite us to confront or challenge our ideas about the world. From Shirley Jackson to Edgar Allan Poe to Stephen King, you'll see works by some of the most celebrated names in the genre. A standout is our first edition of Bram Stoker's Dracula from 1897. Over the past half century, Merril has become a key community hub for the Canadian speculative fiction community. We have hosted launches, book tours, lectures, and have been a go-to resource for writers, researchers, and enthusiasts. The exhibit highlights works by authors who have had a close relationship to Merril over the years, including Cory Doctorow, Neil Gaiman, and Nalo Hopkinson. Hopkinson launched her book Midnight Robber at the Merril Collection in 2000. So how did this unique collection end up at TPL? In 1970, science fiction author and editor Judith Merril donated 5,000 books to TPL. She called it the Spaced Out Library. Now known as the Merril Collection of Science Fiction, Speculation, and Fantasy, it has grown to over 80,000 reference items that are housed on the third floor of TPL's Lillian H. Smith branch.